Hello, I welcome you all. Now in previous video, we have learned on the topic concept of losses. There are six types of losses. Now in this lecture, we will be seeing towards the numericals. Our first one is pretension beam of dimension 200 mm by 300 mm pre-stressed by 10 wires of 7 mm phi initially stressed to 1200 MPa with their centroid located at 100 mm from the soffit. Find loss of pre-stress due to elastic shortening of the concrete, creep of the concrete, shrinkage of the concrete, relaxation of the creep of steel. Find final percentage of the loss of the stress in the steel. Use FCK is equal to 40 MPa, ES is equal to 210 kN per meter square. Relaxation of steel is about 5%. And take creep coefficient as phi is equal to 1.6. Now main thing here that is to be noted is this is the pre-tension beam. Now let us move towards the solution. Now it is given that a beam of dimension 200 mm by 300 mm 200 mm width, 300 mm is the depth. This is the neutral axis. Cable is placed at an eccentricity of 50 mm. Then it is given that 10 wires of 7 mm phi. Initial pre-stress is given as 1200 MPa. And eccentricity we have calculated as 150 minus 100 because it is given in the question that cable is placed at a distance of 100 mm from soffit. Hence 150 minus 100, therefore eccentricity is equal to 50 mm. Also it is given that relaxation of steel to be considered is 5% of initial pre-stress, that is 5% of sigma I. FCK is 40 MPa. Phi given is, that is creep coefficient, 1.6, and Young's modulus of steel is given as 2.1 × 10^5 MPa. Now in question it is given as 210 kN per meter square, that is nothing but GPa. Here we have converted it into MPa. Now let us calculate one by one losses. First loss that is to be determined or asked in the question to determine is loss due to elastic shortening of concrete. Loss due to elastic shortening of concrete, and formula for that is M × FC. In the previous video we have seen various losses and formula there I have explained. Loss due to elastic shortening of concrete can be determined by the formula M × FC. Here M is nothing but modular ratio, ratio of ES by EC. ES is given as 210 GPa. Convert it into MPa, that is 2.1 × 10^5 MPa, and EC can be calculated as 5000 under root FCK. 2.1 × 10^5, 5000 under root FCK is given as 40. Therefore on calculation we will get this value as 6.64. Now initial force, pre-stressing force to be determined is sigma I into A. We are already knowing that stress can be determined as force per unit area. Hence by simplifying for this formula we can determine initial pre-stressing force PI, that is sigma into I. And sigma I is given as 1200. And area of the pre-stressing steel is 10 × π/4 × d², that is 7². That is nothing but 10 number of wires and each wire is of 7 mm phi. Hence 10 × π/4 d². This pi by 4 d square is nothing but area of circular wire. And total pre-stressing force at initial stage is 461.81 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. That is initial pre-stressing force. Therefore, initial pre-stressing force divided by area and pi into E by Z, these are to be calculated. Now from where these values have come? You might be knowing the stress diagram. Now main thing here that is to be kept in mind, as age of concrete index is not mentioned or given. In question, age of the concrete index is not mentioned or given. Hence, during considering the stress diagram, now as age of the concrete is not mentioned or given in the question, you are not supposed to consider the stress diagram due to dead load. Now, here it is the cable. Stress value at this bottom extreme fiber and top extreme fiber will be Pi divided by E. Now, as section is symmetric, stress values will be same at top and bottom extreme fiber. And when pre-stressing force is applied, stress at the bottom extreme fiber here can be calculated as Pi into E by Z. And here, bottom extreme fibers will be in compression, where top extreme fibers will be in tension, and it can be calculated as Pi into E divided by Z. And resultant diagram we are supposed to draw. Now Pi by E, we are knowing Pi we have calculated 461.81 into 10 raised to 3, and area is nothing but area of the section, 200 into 300. Hence we will get stress value of 7.696 MPa, that is values are same at both top and bottom extreme fiber. Next we are supposed to calculate Pi into E by Z. Now Pi is nothing but 461.81 into 10 raised to 3. Eccentricity E we have calculated as, and it is 50 mm, and Z is nothing but BD square by 6. Now section modulus for symmetrical rectangular section Z can be calculated by this formula. And how this formula has arrived, you can see in the previous video once again. There I have mentioned in the video number 1 of this chapter. And if we substitute all these values, B is nothing but 200 mm, D is nothing but 300 mm depth divided by 6, and if we simplify this equation, you will get the value of Pi into E by Z, that is 6.696 MPa. Now take a note that why these values are same, because section is symmetrical, hence top and bottom extreme fiber values are same. Now we are supposed to calculate the resultant. So algebraic summation of the stress values will be 7.696 minus, as here top extreme fibers are in tension, and 7.696 you will get 0, and here 7.696 plus, as here bottom extreme fibers are in compression, hence plus 7.696, total will be getting 15.39 MPa. This is the final stress diagram and which is in compression. Now we are supposed to determine FC. And what is FC? FC is nothing but stress in the concrete at the level of cable. FC is nothing but stress in the concrete at the level of cable. Hence FC value that is to be determined, it is of this level. This FC we are supposed to determine. Now we are supposed to determine FC, that is value of the stress in concrete at the level of cable, this level. Now by symmetry of triangle, we can calculate or determine the value of FC, that is 15.39 divided by total height is equal to FC divided by this height, that is nothing but 200, because in statement it was given that cable is placed at an 100 mm from bottom, hence FC divided by this remaining height will be 200, and by cross multiplication we get stress in the concrete at the level of cable as 10.26 MPa. Hence formula we are knowing, loss due to elastic shortening, is nothing but M into FC. M is nothing but modular ratio that we have calculated, 6.64 into FC 10.26. therefore loss due to elastic shortening of concrete will be 68.12 MPa. Loss due to elastic shortening of concrete. Now second, we'll be determining the loss due to creep of concrete. Second, loss due to creep of concrete, and formula we have seen in previous lecture, that is M into phi into FC. It is given that M is nothing but modular ratio, we have calculated 6.64, phi is nothing but creep coefficient given into the question, 1.6, and FC we have calculated in the first loss calculation and value was 10.26 MPa. Hence loss due to creep of concrete will be 109 MPa, or say Newton per mm square. Don't miss to specify the units. A third loss that is to be calculated is loss due to shrinkage of concrete. Third loss that is to be determined is loss due to shrinkage of concrete, and formula for that is shrinkage strain into ES. Now in question it is mentioned that it is pre-tensioned beam. Hence formula for pre-tension and post-tension is different in case of loss due to shrinkage of concrete, and formula for loss due to shrinkage of concrete in case of pre-tension beam is nothing but 0.0003 into ES, and ES it is given as 210 GPa, and converting it into MPa, 2.1 into 10 raised to 5 MPa. Therefore loss due to shrinkage of concrete will be 63 MPa. Since shrinkage strain for pre-tension member is nothing but 0.0003. Next we'll be determining loss due to relaxation of steel. Loss due to relaxation of steel, that is nothing but given that, consider loss due to relaxation of steel as 5% of initial pre-stress, that is 5% of sigma I. 5/100 into 1200, that is nothing but 60 MPa. This is nothing but loss due to relaxation of steel. Now it was asked to calculate the total loss into the pre-tension member and also calculate the percentage loss as compared to the pre-stressing force. Let us see. Now total loss will be due to all the four losses that occurred in the pre-tensioned member. Loss first, that is nothing but loss due to elastic shortening of concrete. Second, loss due to creep of concrete. Third, loss due to shrinkage of concrete. And fourth, loss due to relaxation of steel. Now loss due to Elastic shutting of concrete by calculated is 68.12 MPa. Loss due to creep of concrete is 109 MPa. Loss due to shrinkage of concrete is 63 MPa and loss due to relaxation of steel is 60 MPa. Addition of all this will give you total loss occurring in that pre-tension member. It is nothing but 300.12 MPa. Hence, percentage loss in the member will be total loss divided by initial pre-stress into 100. Total loss is nothing but 300.12 MPa. Initial pre-stress sigma y is given as 1200 MPa. Initial pre-stress sigma I, that is 1200 MPa into 100. Therefore, percentage loss in the pre-tension member here is 25.01%. In this way, you are supposed to calculate all the required losses according to the member, and as it was pre-tension member given into the question, hence only 4 losses will be occurring here, and you are supposed to calculate at the end percentage loss into the member by the formula total loss divided by sigma I into 100. And as it was given into the question, it is pre-tension member. So try to rewind that we have concluded or studied in the previous lecture of concept of losses. It was told that in pre-tension member only 4 losses will take place, and the losses which does not occur are loss due to friction and loss due to slip of anchorage. These 2 losses will not occur if the member is pre-tensioned.